Welcome to an exciting demo on web scraping and text analytics. Web scraping has got many applications such as academic research, market analysis, or building your own data product. However, you can experience the real power when you combine web scraping with text analytics. In this demo, we will web scrape Hugging Face website, which has got the largest collection of AI and generative AI models. We will then make some various analysis such as stunning visualization to understand who are the top model providers. We will use text clustering to cluster similar models together, and we will use advanced topic modeling to understand what these models do. I will show you this demo using my platform experiencedatascience.com. You can also try out this demo with your own data and you do not need to code. So let's jump in. Before we go into web scraping, let me just give you a basic introduction on how generally the websites are structured. The websites are essentially in HTML format. It has a high-level element called the tag, and the tag can have a class and can have an attribute. And under this tag, you can have various text information as well as you can have tabular data. Now, let us analyze the Hugging Face website, and I will start by clicking on the models section, and let me also sort it by trending. At the time of recording, it has got about 449,943 models available, and they are also split into almost about 15,000 pages. Now, let me right-click and inspect the HTML behind the model, which is the Microsoft Phi2. And here you see that the HTML elements, and we can see that there is a tag called as A, and it has got a class called Block B2. And then you also have the model name available as the attribute href. You have a similar pattern for all other models. For example, here you can see for the model Mistral AI, you have a tag called A and you have a class called Block B2. And of course, you have the attribute href as the Mistral model. You can also note that as I click on different pages, the URL indicates the name of the page -1. And sort equal to trending. So for example, if I click on page 3, I will have page equal to 2 and sort equal to trending. Now, let me create an Excel file which will have all the URLs which we want to scrap, and we'll try to scrap the first 10 pages. So the URLs correspond to huggingface.com/models/p=0 till p equal to 10. Now let me go to my platform experiencedatascience.com and go to the experience web scraping and text analytics. Now I have already set up all the data sets which are required, but for the demo purpose, I will show you on how to load the data related to all the URLs which we want to scrap. So let me go ahead and then drag and drop the CSV file which has got all the URLs which we want to scrap and then save it. So in a while, my data set is saved and is available over here. Let me now go ahead and select this data set and click on analytics. Let us first start with displaying the data. So I will go ahead and select few records to display all the columns and then execute it. All right, so in a while I have my results. I see that the data has got all the URLs which we want to scrap. Now let us go to the web scraping. First, I will select the column which has got the URL. I will also enter the tag name, which is A. I will then enter the class name, which is Block B2, and I will enter the attribute name, which is href. Now, because there is no table, we will just enter none for the tag for the tables as well as class name for the tables. I will also save the output as a data set so that we can use it further. Now, let me go ahead and execute the web scraping. Now, this process might take a bit of time based on the number of URLs what you have. So, let me go ahead and show you the results. Alright, so we have our web scraping results and I see that I have the URL name, I have the status with a value of 200, which indicates that the scraping has been successful. I have the tag name, the class name, as well as all the text related to the model. I can also download this information in Excel if required. And you'll see that in total, we have scraped almost about 300 models, which is pretty impressive. Now, looking at this column href attribute, we see that it has got the name of the company which provides the AI model, followed by the name of the AI model. So we can do something very interesting. We can try to analyze what are the different companies which are providing these models and how many models does each company provide. In order to do that, we need to split this particular field into the company and the model. And we will do that using the splitting functionality. Now, let me first start by selecting the data set which was generated as a result of web scraping. And then let me go ahead and select the column attribute which we want to split. Let me also enter the split character, which is a forward slash. I will also enter the maximum number of splits as 3, which will split the href into 3 parts. And I will also enter a filler character, which is a character which will get filled if the number of splits are less than 3. Now, let me go ahead and make some other settings. I will also save the output as a data set and let me now execute this. All right, so the text splitting is now done and I have created 3 additional columns. The attribute href00, which is the blank, and which corresponds to everything before the first forward slash. The column attribute href01, which corresponds to the company name. The column attribute href2, which corresponds to the model name. I would also like to add a dummy column which contains a constant value. So let me do that by creating a new column. And first, I will select the data set, which is the output of text splitting. Let me enter the name of the new column as dummy. The column value will be a constant value of 1. And of course, I will save the output of this data set. Now, let me execute this. And in a while, I have my results. And I've just added a new column dummy, which has got a fixed value of 1. So we are now all set to do further analysis and make some stunning visualization. In order to analyze the company and the model names, let me go ahead and make a dendrogram visualization. Let me first start by changing the dataset so that we are using the data which was generated after creating our dummy column. Now, dendrograms are essentially a hierarchical visualization. So I will go ahead and select my first level of hierarchy as the company name, which is in the column attribute href01. I will select the second level of hierarchy as the model name, which is in the column attribute href02. I will keep all other levels of hierarchy as none. And for the value column, I will select dummy, which is equal to 1. Now you know why I have created the dummy column. I also need to aggregate the value of a dummy column, but I will just select it as average and make some other settings and let us now execute this. Wow, I now see a very stunning looking visual. It has got the first level as the company name, the second level as the model name, and I see that there are 2 companies, The Bloke, which is a very funny name, and Stability AI, which seems to be making many models compared to others. So let us now filter the data so that I have the data selected for the company name, The Bloke and Stability AI. And let me now re-execute the dendrogram. All right, so the visualization now only has two companies. And we see that The Bloke is making many AI models based on Mistral, Llama, Dolphin and others. And Stability AI is also making many models such as Stable Diffusion, ST Turbo and few others. Now let us do more web scraping, and I would like to scrape the model details which are available over here. For example, let us inspect the model details for Microsoft 5.2, and let me inspect the page, and I see that all the model description is available under the element with tag as div and the class as relative MD-MT2. I also see that the URL of the page which has got the model details is huggingface.com/the company name/the model name. So let me now create a new column which is based on the href attribute which we had obtained in the previous web scraping. And let me go ahead and create a new column which is going to be the URL model, and we will prefix it with https://huggingface.com. Let me also save the output as a data set, and let me now execute this. And in a while, I see that in my output, I have the URL of the model, which we can now use it for web scraping. Now, let me go ahead and do the web scraping. But first, I will change the data set so that I'm using the data set which has got the URL of the model. I will select the URL to scrap as the URL for the model. I will select the tag name as div. I will select the class name as relative MD-MT2, and for the attribute name, class name and table name, I will just set it as null. I will also save the output as a new data set, and let me now start the web scraping. All right, my friends, I just scraped the entire model details from the Hugging Face website. The model description is available under this column text value, and as a next step, let us do some cutting edge text analytics on this model details. But before we do text analytics, generally it is a good practice to clean the text which has been just web scraped. And this will help us to be very efficient in text analytics. Let me first start by selecting the data set which was generated due to web scraping. And let me go ahead and select the column for text cleaning. Let me also select the text cleaning methods, and I will convert all the text to lowercase. I will remove special characters as well as I will remove the new line characters. I will also save the output as a data set, and let me now execute the text cleaning. All right, my text cleaning has been done, and as you can see that in the clean text, I do not have special characters as well as I do not have any new line characters, and this is going to be much more efficient when I'm doing further text analytics. So let us start with text clustering, which is going to help us to group all the models which have similar descriptions into a common cluster. We'll start by selecting the data set which was generated as a result of text cleaning. I will go ahead and select the column for clustering. I will also select few of the columns which I will need in my final output. And let us try to make 10 clusters. And for text clustering algorithm, let me go ahead and select the OpenAI embeddings. Now, OpenAI is the company behind ChatGPT, and it does very efficient text clustering. I will also save the output as a data set. And let me now execute the text clustering. All right, so I have my results of text clustering. Each dot here corresponds to a model, and the color of the dot corresponds to the cluster to which the model is assigned. I can hover over these dots to see the model descriptions. So for example, here in this particular cluster, I see that this cluster corresponds to all the models which are based on the large language model called Llama, which is coming from Facebook. And if I hover over this cluster, I see that all the models are related to GGUF, which is a special format for storing large language models. So you can see that we went from web scraping to very powerful text clustering, and we now have a very good idea on what are the type of AI models which are available on huggingface.com. Though text clustering is very powerful, we still have to manually eyeball to understand the topics which are covered in the text. So let us take our text analytics to the next level by doing topic modeling. Topic modeling is a very powerful algorithm which helps us to automatically determine what are the topics or the subjects which are included in the text. So let me go ahead and select topic modeling. Let me first start by selecting the text column which I will require for topic modeling. I will also select some more columns which I will need in my final output. Let's say we want to identify 10 topics, and each topic can have maximum of 10 tokens. We will also save the output as a data set, and let me now go ahead and execute the topic modeling algorithm. Alright, so now I see the results of my topic modeling algorithm as a heat map visualization. Now on this heat map visualization, on the y-axis I have different topics, and on the x-axis I have different words or tokens. The color of the heat map is an indication on what are the tokens or words which are relevant for a particular topic. For example, we see that for the topic 9, the most important words are CCP, GGUF, GPU, and Llama. Now this indicates that topic 9 is mostly related to very efficient storage of Llama-based models and then use of GPU processing. Similarly, we see that the topic 5 is related to chat and GPT, which means that this topic is related to models based on the ChatGPT large language model. You can also download the results as an Excel file, which will have all the models and the predicted topic for each model. For example, we can filter on topic 9, and here I see all the models which are assigned to topic 9. As you can see that the models are mostly related to Llama and GGUF, and most of the models are coming from our favorite company, The Block. Alright my friends, hopefully you enjoyed the video. As you saw that we went from a website to powerful text analytics without writing a single line of code. Please subscribe and comment below on what website would you be interested to scrap. And I would recommend you to try out experiencedatascience.com from going from website scrapping to text analytics in a very efficient way. Thank you for watching and see you soon in the next video.